All right, we are recording now. Today is
Tuesday,
August 12th.
I think so.
Yes, 2014.
That's right.
And we are interviewing Angela Miraglia at her home. Angela is how old now?
87.
87 years old. And when is your date of birth?
1/30/27.
January 30th, 1927. My name is John Miraglia, and I will be the interviewer. And Angela Miraglia is my mother. We are recording this conversation for the Brooklyn Public Library. Our Streets, Our Stories, a Brooklyn Neighborhood Oral History Project. And this is for the Leonard Street branch, which is located at 81 DeVue Street in Brooklyn, New York. You say DeVue Street, right?
That's right. That's the right street.
Okay, start, Mom. Tell me where you grew up.
In this neighborhood. At 240 Leonard Street. I came here when I was 2 years old.
Right? You came to this house, 240 Leonard Street, when you were 2 years old.
Right.
That means that was 85 years ago.
Exactly right.
And where were you those 2 years before, where had you lived?
I'm not sure, we lived on either, I'm trying to think, but this is, what was that street? What street is that?
Metropolitan?
Yeah, either that.
A couple of blocks away.
Exactly.
Not too far.
Not too far.
And...
but I only remember this house.
I only remember this house, because you came here when you were 2 years old.
No, I'm not going to remember.
That'll be about 1929, right?
Yeah.
And who were your parents? What were their names?
Anthony Serino, and Angelina Serino.
Okay, so Miraglia.
Mother and father.
But that was your maiden name, Serino.
Yes, right. S-E-R-I-N-O. Right.
And what did they do for a living?
My father was a tailor.
Uh-huh.
My mother was a seamstress. She could sew.
Oh, okay. Where did they work?
Where did they live? Here.
Where did they work?
My father worked, I think, for a store, like in Manhattan.
Worked in Manhattan?
Yeah, worked in Manhattan.
In a factory?
No.
In a store. Right.
Like a big department store.
Okay.
Who's that?
Oh, that's Angie.
What does she want?
Let's see. I'll have to answer the door. Wait a minute. All right, we were talking about your parents. You said that your father was a tailor and your mother was a seamstress. And he worked in Manhattan.
Yeah, like in a big department store.
So wait, your father was an American?
No,
of course not. So tell me, who was your father?
Anthony
Serino. And when did he come to this country?
That's a good question.
Where did he come from?
From Italy.
And do you know what part of Italy? You don't remember? Was it Southern Italy?
Huh?
Southern Italy, right?
Probably. Who knows?
You know. You have to remember. Campobasso.
Yeah.
In the province of Molise.
Where is that?
On the Adriatic coast.
Oh, near the water?
Yeah, near the water. Right. So it's below Abruzzi.
Oh.
And above Apulia.
Oh, boy. It's pretty big.
It's not so big.
No.
And what about your mother?
She wasn't in the same. She was a different vicinity.
She was different. She was from outside of...
yeah, probably.
Benevento.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah.
Right. So where did they get married?
There, in Italy.
In Italy. Do you know what year they got married?
No, because... Aunt Mary was born there.
They took her as a little baby, four years old or five years old. Okay.
And then she had two other children, but they died.
All right. So they came here to this country with Aunt Mary, I think it was around 1915,
1918. No, she was young, Joe.
She was young?
Yeah.
She was born 1905, I know.
Yeah, like that. She was born in 1905.
So she was five, they came in 1910.
That's it, yeah. Right.
So that was Aunt Mary. That was your oldest sister.
Right, that's Aunt Mary, yeah.
And how many brothers and sisters did you have?
Aunt Mary and Aunt Josie.
Yeah, two sisters.
Two sisters, right.
Okay. And your brother, four brothers. And four brothers. So there were seven in your family.
Right,
and
right.
You were the youngest.
Right, right.
So Aunt Mary was the oldest, 1905. You were the youngest. You were born 1927, so it's 23 years apart.
Right. She could have been my mother.
I remember her. She lived in this house.
Yeah.
The same house that you've been living in for
all these years.
85 years. Wow. Where I was born in 1953.
You were born here.
I was born in this house, right. And then Aunt Mary lived around the corner on Powers Street.
Yeah.
And then she moved upstairs and you moved downstairs when you got
married. But that was after her husband died.
Yeah, right. Yeah. In the 60s.
Yeah, right.
And then she lived upstairs, and she was like my grandmother.
Right.
But she was my aunt.
Yeah, right.
So when you were growing up in this neighborhood, do you remember the library on DeVue Street?
Of course, sure.
What did you do there?
I don't remember going when we were little. When we were a little older, we went.
And what did you do there?
I used to have a story hour.
Story hour.
They would have a story, yeah.
You would sit and you would listen to someone read a story.
Story, yeah.
Oh, who did you go with?
Probably little kids up on my age. Who knows, like my girlfriend Annie.
And which school did you go to with Annie? Where did you go to school?
PSAT. Over here on Leonard Street.
Leonard Street in Mordred.
Mordred.
Okay, right. So you went. So I guess you were six when you went, about 1933, you went there, right?
Yeah, and then we went to 196.
Junior high, you went to 196.
Yeah, and then from there we went to Eastern District.
And then you went to Eastern District. Arlene found your diploma here.
Yeah, and where is that from?
January 1942, junior high school. So I guess this is from 196. It says right here, junior high school 196.
This is it?
This is your...
Diploma.
Junior high diploma. You kept it all these years. Wow. 1942. Angela Sfino has completed satisfactorily the course of study of the junior high schools and has merited the approbation of the principal. The approbation of the principal.
What does that mean?
I don't know. It must be something good. And teachers for scholarship and integrity. So then you graduated in 196 in 1942, and you went to Eastern District.
That's high school.
High school, and Arlene, your daughter.
Yes.
We'll have to talk about your daughters and children in a minute. Found your high school diploma.
That's it?
That's it.
Where the hell she found this? I don't know.
I don't know.
She opened up a drawer.
So it says here you graduated from high school, Eastern District High School, the class of January 1945. You graduated in January. Junior high and high school.
Yeah.
Not June.
No, January.
I wonder why. Do you remember why? Okay. And I see over here that your name is listed with an asterisk.
Yeah. That little star next to it.
Little star. It says you belong to the Arista Society. Remember what that was?
You're talking about 87, many years ago.
1945.
Yeah, well, that's a long time ago.
Well, I think it's an honor society.
Well, see that?
That still exists in the high schools today.
That's good.
We've had academic diploma, commercial diploma, and general diploma. Do you remember the differences?
Yeah, I don't know. What's the difference?
I will have to research that one.
Okay.
All right, so there you go. You graduated in 1945, and then... Do you recall any of your teachers?
You what?
Do you remember any of your teachers in the school? Any teachers? Any names?
Yeah.
What they looked like?
They were all old.
They were all old.
Yeah, they were old.
Teachers were old then.
Yeah, they were old. That's right. There were no young teachers.
Oh, okay. So you graduated in 1945 from high school, Eastern District, which you said was on Bushwick Avenue?
Yeah.
Where was it?
Eastern District? Yeah. No. Eastern District was... near Broadway somewhere.
Oh, right.
I don't think it's there anymore.
I think they changed the name.
Yeah, that's it.
Another research project. Okay, so what did you do after high school?
Got a job.
You got a job. Where? Where? Didn't you work for Social Security or something?
Not Social Security.
Some city agency?
What the hell did you do? But I worked.
You worked. How did you get there?
We used to walk there, so it could have been like on the north side. I don't know.
You don't know. How long did you work there?
Yeah.
You don't know how long you worked there?
No, so long ago, I don't remember. Not terrible.
So what did you do when you were a kid here, or a young lady in the 1940s?
Who the heck knows? I don't remember.
You remember what you do and your friends did for fun? Did you go to the movies?
Oh, yeah, we went to the movies.
Well, yeah? Which movies did you go to?
They used to have The Rainbow on
Bushwick.
Now it was on Graham Avenue.
On Graham Avenue? The Dumps, I thought.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
See, they don't have anything like that anymore. And then there's one on Broadway, too, another movie.
Okay. They don't have those anymore. Let's see if this thing's still working. Yeah, it's still working. Okay. So, you remember going to the movies? Do you remember any movies you saw?
No, I don't remember.
Do you remember any actors you liked?
No.
How about your friends? Do you remember any of your friends?
Yeah, my girlfriend Annie. She just lived across the street.
Where?
Across the street, second house.
Well, who's there now? What do you mean? Patrick Cohen?
Somebody sold it. They sold that house.
Well, who was there when I was growing up? Annie wasn't there.
Yes. Oh, then maybe I've moved.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I don't know.
Pat Chacon. How about Pat Chacon?
They lived across the street.
Was that the house you're talking about?
No. She lived the second house.
Dennis's house?
Huh?
Dennis.
No. Two more over. The second house only.
Where the Montellos lived?
Yeah, that's it. Where they lived.
Oh,
yeah.
Where the Montellos lived.
I wonder whatever happened to them.
They moved to Texas.
Oh, to Texas.
In the 1960s.
Wow. I remember we used to go to the beach. I drove.
You drove to the beach?
Yeah, we used to go to the beach.
Which beach?
Coney Island we went to.
Who would go?
I would take Angie Kame and the girl who lived across the street with their kids. We used to go. I took them.
Me too?
No, I don't think.
I don't remember Coney Island.
No.
It was before my time.
Yeah, before your time. That's when I was dry.
In the late 40s.
Yeah, like this.
So where'd you get the car?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Well, Daddy always had a car. He used to have a car. I don't know where he had a car. It was this sort of uncle, what do you call, gave him his car? And Angie's husband. What was his name? Patty. But,
yeah, Uncle Patty.
Yeah, he gave him, I think, the car. Gave it to us.
Oh, he gave him a car, and you would drive it?
Yeah.
He would give you his car?
Yeah, because he bought another car.
Well, he was a big shot.
So then
you knew, when did you meet Dad? What year was that?
Very good. When Henry was 16 years old, I went with my two friends. We crashed, we went to the party. They had it down around the corner.
So Uncle Henry was born, I think, around 1930.
Yeah, because Daddy's born 29, and Daddy's born in January, but he's born November. So that's like almost 2 years, but it's like, a year and so many months.
So 1930, so you went to his sweet 16 party.
Yeah, and then that's how I met
1946.
Daddy.
1946. You met your husband in 1946.
Right.
I see. Yeah. And then you got the car from his brother, and you went to the beach.
Right.
And then you got married.
Yeah, 1950 we got married, right?
That's right, I think.
1950. Yeah.
So what was life like around here in 1950 when you got married?
Quiet.
Do you remember any stores?
No.
Where'd you go shopping?
Good question. I don't know, John.
You don't remember where you went shopping?
Don't remember. So long ago, John. How can you remember? I can't remember.
Do you remember cooking?
Yeah. But my mother used to be down here, and we were upstairs.
That's right.
See? So we used to eat with my mother.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so say that again. What's your question?
Why does the library want to know, ask these kind of questions? Why?
Well, this is called an oral history project, so they want to record some historical information about this neighborhood.
Oh.
Right from the horse's mouth, so to speak. Yeah.
That's right. I mean, look how long that they've been there. That's right. A long time, John, 103 years. Come on.
That's right.
A long time.
So I remember some of these pictures that we saw when you got married. I remember pictures of this house when I was a kid here in the 1950s. And we had...
There's pictures of the house.
Yeah, here's the house. Mm-hmm. We had this kind of, what do they call that, shingle style. Scale. Oh. Fish scale. Shingles.
Oh.
Okay, Queen Anne style. Remember the stoop?
Yeah, of course. Remember that stoop?
Tell the story about why you have a brick stoop. Why do you have a
brick? It's a crash. I had a crash. Somebody crashed into it. Into our gate.
Do you remember who crashed into the gate?
Oh, it was a big accident, I know.
This is right in front of the house on Leonard Street, right?
Yeah, on Leonard.
Because it used to be a two-way.
Yeah, it used to be.
And then you told me once there was a fire truck and an oil truck.
That's right, and they collided.
Going in opposite directions.
Yeah.
And then one of the trucks...
Went into here.
Right into the house, right?
Right, into here, right.
So did anybody get hurt?
Thank goodness, no.
So then they had to pay for rebuilding the front of the house
yeah.
and the gate.
Yeah.
And then we had all that brick. Remember, we had all that big brick gate.
Yeah.
The brick looked like a fortress.
Yeah.
But that was gone. That came down, I think, in what, the late 70s?
Probably.
Then we put up a new stoop.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, do you remember these pics?
Where'd
you get married?
St. Mary's.
Where is that?
Leonard and Marjorie.
Right. And then I went to St. Mary's grammar school.
Yeah.
I started there in 1959.
Right.
I graduated in 1967.
And then you went to high school.
And then I went to high school. I went to Bishop Auckland High School in fourth grade. And then you, how many children do you have?
Three.
Right. And I have two younger sisters. They both went, Doretta and Arlene went to St. Mary's.
Right.
Grammar school. Immaculate Conception was the official name.
And then all Doretta went to St. Nicholas.
That's right.
Then they closed when Arlene had to go, and then Arlene went to St. Michael's in New York.
That's right. On Olive. She went to Doretta went to St. Nicholas on Olive Street. Up near Bushwick Avenue.
Right, right.
And then she graduated high school, I guess, around 1975. And then she went to work for the United Nations.
Yeah.
And she's been there ever since.
19 or 18.
She was 18, and she completed her college degree at night and her master's degrees at night.
Now, when she leaves 60, you have to force retirement. You have to leave. So she'll get a good pension.
Yeah, she'll get a good pension. Don't tell too many people.
Yeah? What'd you say?
I said, don't tell too many people. So I'm looking at your wedding pictures.
That's a long time. 1950.
Right. It was a pretty church.
Yeah. Oh, St. Mary's, yeah.
And do you know what happened to the church now?
I don't know. What are they going to do? They're going to make... condos.
That's right. They're gonna make condos. Remember, we drove by.
Yeah, we saw.
They have all condos. The church became a big condominium.
Mm.
Yeah. We went there. I went there for 8 years at the school. It was the Sisters of Saint Joseph.
Where is that?
That was the congregation of nuns.
Oh.
Okay. Anything else you want to say about this neighborhood? You like this neighborhood?
Of course. I've been here all my life.
And you don't want to sell this house. I hear this house is worth a lot of money now.
How much?
A lot of money.
Did you ever ask how much it was worth?
No. Yeah, different. Over $1 million.
Over $1 million?
Over $1 million.
Why? Why so expensive?
because it has a good location.
Because you can walk to the subway.
And you can get to Manhattan.
Well, that you have to take that. Again, I'm talking about you walk to the subway to get to Manhattan.
And the land was for the taking.
The land was what?
The land was for the taking. All these people came and said, hey, look at this neighborhood. It's so convenient.
There's no houses for rent.
Right.
Everything is filled. There's no vacancies.
So if you could have all that money, why don't you sell it and live in a nice, comfortable, assisted living place?
I don't want to live in living, John. Like, we went to a place, guy took a Sunday. Who wants to go there? Well, I mean, the place was nice, but they're all old.
They're all old. Well, how old are you?
Yeah, well, I know, but don't even, some of them, maybe some of them are even younger, but they look older.
Oh, so you
don't want to go live in a place like that.
Oh, you'd rather stay here. You
That's
think,
right.
You think you'll stay younger here.
Right. This is my house. This is my... I grew up here. When I'm gone, then you just sell the house and you make money.
Well, we want you to be happy.
I'm happy.
So you're happy. So we're all happy.